So in this example, we are going to discuss a vector space R2, which is R cross R. With respect to addition operation, I'm going to define as x comma y, x dash y dash will be added as x plus x dash and y plus y dash. And k dot xy, this is scalar multiplication, I'm going to define as kx comma ky. And we are going to prove that this set R2 with respect to this addition and with respect to this multiplication is a vector space. So let us see how to solve this problem. So first property is closure with respect to addition. So I will take first vector u, which is x comma y. I'm going to represent a vector now by a bar. So u bar is an element of R2, which is a vector space, and v bar is also x dash y dash, which is also an element of the vector space R2. So when I add them, if I take u bar plus v bar, I'm going to get x plus x dash, y plus y dash by the addition defined above. And this is also an element of R2, which is in V. So we got that u belongs to V and v bar also belongs to V. Then u bar plus v bar also belongs to the vector space v bar. If I try to look at the associativity property, u bar plus v bar plus w bar, this is nothing but x comma y. The second vector v bar I'm going to take is x dash y dash plus third vector I will now take as x double dash comma y double dash. When I add them, I will get this as x comma y. I will add the people which are in the bigger bracket first, which is x dash plus x double dash comma y dash plus y double dash. Now I will add these two vectors also, which will give me x plus x dash plus x double dash comma y plus y dash plus y double dash. This will be my left hand side of associativity. When I similarly solve it, u bar plus v bar and plus w bar, when I solve this in the same above fashion, I will get the same answer, x plus x dash plus x double dash and y plus y dash plus y double dash. We will get the same answer. So this means that u plus v plus w is equal to u plus v plus w. So this associative with respect to addition operation will also hold. If I consider the zero as zero vector, which is 0, 0, then this person will serve as an identity with respect to the addition operation. This means that u bar plus 0 bar means x comma y plus 0 comma 0 will again turn to be x comma y, which is u bar. So I got that u bar plus 0 bar is again equal to u bar. The inverse of a vector u bar, if I take a vector u bar, then I will add minus of u bar to that person. So that will give me xy plus minus x minus y. When I add them, I will get 0 plus 0 comma 0. So I declare that this is 0 bar now, and therefore what I get is that u bar plus minus of u bar is giving me the identity 0 bar. Means minus u bar is the inverse of the vector u bar with respect to addition operation. Next is commutativity with respect to addition. U bar plus v bar means x comma y plus x dash y dash is the same as, is equal to actually x plus x dash and y plus y dash, which I can rewrite as x dash plus x comma y dash plus y, and which I can again separate out as x dash y dash plus xy, which is nothing but v bar plus u bar. So the commutativity also holds with respect to addition operation. We want to find the role of one in the vector space. Who is one in this vector space? The vector one, the person one, this one must be a scalar. So from the real numbers, we will choose the real number one. This one will do my job, means one into u bar will be equal to 1 into x comma y. As defined above, this will be 1x, 1y, and that is nothing but xy. And this is again u bar. So what I have concluded from this is that 1 into u bar is equal to u bar. So identity with respect to scalar multiplication, which is 1, is also there. Next is I have distributivity. I'll take k dot u bar plus v bar is equal to k dot u bar is x comma y plus v bar is x dash y dash, which is equal to k dot x plus x dash. First I will add them, because bracket inside the bracket I have addition, x plus x dash comma y plus y dash, which is equal to, this k will now multiply inside by the definition, k dot x plus x dash comma k dot y plus y dash. So x, x dash, k, all are real numbers. So this I can write as kx plus ky. So kx plus k dash, kx dash and ky plus ky dash. This is the left hand side. Let us write the right hand side. K dot u plus k dot v. If I do this calculation, I'm going to get kxy plus k x dash y dash, which is the same as kx ky plus kx dash ky dash. And when I add them, I'm going to get kx plus kx dash comma ky plus ky dash. You see that the left hand side and the right hand side are matching each other. So I declare that these two quantities, k dot u plus v, is the same as k dot u plus k dot v. So the distributivity property, scalar multiplication is distributed over a vector addition, is proved. Let's now distribute the vector k plus l dot u bar. This is nothing but k plus l. U bar is vector x plus y, x comma y. This scalar will go and multiply the component to insides, because that is the definition of scalar multiplication. So it is k plus l x comma k plus l y, which is equal to kx plus lx comma ky plus ly. I will separate these components now. Kx ky plus lx ly, k x comma y plus l x comma y, which is nothing but k u bar plus l u bar. So we have proved that left hand side is directly equal to the right hand side, means k plus l dot u bar is the same as k dot u bar plus l dot u bar. Okay, the last property which is remaining, that is k l u bar. So we'll start l u bar. So we have proved the last property also. So all the properties of the vector space are now satisfied, and therefore we declare that R2 with respect to that addition and scalar multiplication is a vector space. Therefore R2 with respect to the above addition and scalar multiplication is a vector space.